Go into circle, small circle, please. All right. Make sure you've got the chin, and you're going to do the cradle. You keeping that chin? You keeping the chin? To your move. Alright, good. Switch it. Stay inside the circle in the middle. And when you do the eye, now get to your head in a rib. Go straight. Straight across. Yeah. Good. This time, go ahead. Do it again. This time, post your leg out as a tripod to stop that. When he does that, I'm going to shoulder roll. Put your head in the rib. Head in the rib. Forehead in the rib. Tripod. All right, now cut double.
Do what?
Cut double. Whoever shoots is going to tripod, try to okay, and then it's going to get away, and then you're going to try to cut double. On the knee, chop the knee, and sideways. Go to your cradle. No, go to your cradle. You're going to go to your cradle, and then you're going to tripod. You're going to go to your cradle or you're going to tripod out.
And the guy who got away, yeah. Right. And the red rim match, why don't you stand up for that? That way you can keep your power with you. You want it hit in with you. Because you're gonna need that power. So don't stay down there. You try pot, get out, and then yeah, like that. Good. Good. The way to control yourself is obviously. He's too big for you. So.
Behind, but he followed me, and because he followed me, I have a hard time getting this hand back, right? This hand back. So as he follows me, then I'm gonna shock him here, put this back, and that other hand here, right in the armpit, behind the armpit. That's what you want. That's all you need. That's only so that he doesn't reach back. He doesn't reach back. Throw and drop together. So you're gonna do the shot. Try to go behind, follow you, shut it. Try to follow you, shut it. Catholic behind or something else. Now, what happens is they follow you sometimes, they'll follow you, and then they'll realize that they keep up, they're going to try to tie pop. Then they're going to try to get up, because they know that you're going to try to get behind. So now you're going to do the long hand. Remember long hand? You're going to hold this. When you try to pop, so pretend you follow me, and then all of a sudden you just buck up. Yeah, they're like, you know, buck up. Because it's like, oh, hey, you know, so I'm trying to get behind him. So right here, you're going to drop your shoulder, pop, pull, and drive. Okay?
He thinks he's going to reset. So he's going to go back to neutral. Take the opportunity to see. To the side. Now drive this, drive forward to the side. Right there, and right there. It's a feel. Once you go this way, then you know you can get your hands and go swim over the bottom. Wrong hand. Slam. Always slam. Drive forward, slam. Okay? cross here. And now, you're going to have a hard time here now. You need to be here. Okay?
So hip high, right there. Yeah, the other person. Right away, he's taking you down, you're gonna go here. Here, and square up. Don't go flat on your butt. Yeah, like that. Good again. When you're falling down, start twisting in here. A little bit more. Because you're kind of flat like that still. Fall to your hip. Yeah, like that. A little bit. And you're gonna do that on the money. Now when he's taking you down, you don't even move in half. You don't wait. You wait, you can try. Alright? Now you also do the single and pulse out. Simple. Do a low single, head on the inside. I just want to make sure that anything that in the first round, that takes place in the first round, you need to be careful with. Kind of do a sweep. You're going to cut the corner. You're going to do the shin loser, counter. Alright. And then high low to get behind. Move your leg back. Got it? Anytime. Sweep it. Wizard. Hey, shin wizard. Towards. Drop your shoulder to shoulder in front. Drop your shoulder down towards his head. Right. Drop your shoulder in. Like that. Now have high low. Get behind. No, I'm gonna go behind you from the point. You feel tired, so you're gonna feel pressure. Right there, go straight to your shin. Yeah, right there. Drop your shoulder down. Yeah, not high low. Yeah, right there. You gotta act like you're resting here. You gotta get into that movement. You only got 1 month. So it's a bit like you're resting. So when you're doing it, you get a feel like it's really taking place with your mind's body. Like that. You can act like it's really taking place. Like you take it to do it,
make sure this stays flat. Okay, you don't want to twist your ankle. So it has to stay flat. Okay. So right here.
Lay back. You have to feel comfortable laying on them. You have to if you want to. Lay on that shoulder. Knee goes back, lay on the shoulder. Yeah, like that. Okay. All right, let's get this thing going.
Hey,
Mark. Hey. Do the, now you get to lay. These shoes are going to fly. Cry, remember to hit the leg, cry. Cry the thigh. Cry the same side, cry, cross face. Inside cross face. Maintain the up. Yeah, you can hold over. Let yourself. Okay. You have to distribute your weight, alright? Cry. No. Cry the thigh. No, cry the thigh. Come on. If you don't cry the thigh, it's going to come around you. It's going to come around you. How many shoot you got to lay?
Cry. Cry is bad. And cross face. Cry. Hip down, cross face. Yeah. Slowly, take it easy. Good. Switch it. Get that deep. It's very important you do that. A lot of you guys, none of you guys do that. I want to make sure you guys can do that. Go ahead, switch it. Cry. Hip down, cross face, cry. Try. Try. You got that? Alright. Now, that's if he's got the leg. And then off of this, he's got the leg. If he's got the leg, you pry, right? Now you keep the momentum. You're going to pry. Now, if you're going to do, you're going to come here. You're gonna switch here. But you gotta go right away over here. Pull it. Again, if he's got the leg, you're gonna pry, and then you're gonna attack the cross face. Now from the cross face, you're gonna use bulldozer, right? Or here. Double, come bring it over, switch it over, and come around. Pull and pull. You're doing the same thing. You're just going to decide on the same thing. Again, he's got the leg. What do? First pull, always. He's got my leg. You always cry. Cry. Here's the cross face. Now, the cry hand has two choices. One, I go back behind it to a bulldozer, or I let go and I come here instead. So he's got my leg. I'm going to cry. He doesn't want to let go. I can bulldozer, or by this time I'm not going to bulldozer. I'm going to stay here. I'm going to come here instead of back. Get it? I'm going to go here. I pull, and then I come over this way. I'm gonna pull this while I go behind so that he feels he wants to let go. So I'm gonna pull, and my thighs are gonna help me. So I'm gonna pull, and I'm gonna pull here. My thigh is gonna be there. Cross over. Always cry. You're starting the same position always. You're just gonna finish one way or the other. Go. You have options now. Shoot. Cry. You cross face. You're in cross face. Now right there, instead of going at that bulldozer, yeah, now come over with the right hand. Just saying.
catch that ankle.
Amen.
Make sure you try to catch it.
Yeah,
yeah. You got to try to catch it. Try to pull it. Try to catch it. That way, he's stopped. He's not going on.
All right, move on.
Last one, last part of this series.
He shoots, he's moved the legs from the pride, but this time he doesn't knock.
All right, usually he doesn't knock. We should have done that one first, though.
This time he doesn't knock.
So rather than before he knocks, he's in the lock. Right? So you can go here, here, here. High up. No lock. And then here, here, here. It's like a rooster. The first thing is no lock, it's a rooster. Try that.
Try low.
Okay. So if you just got no lock, you're gonna wizard, no wizard first. Wizard. And come up slowly. If we come here, yeah, there you go. Remember, high low is a wizard. Basically it's a wizard. You're gonna turn it, you're gonna turn into a wizard. And then come in with the elbow. Your right hand, you gotta come in with the wizard. The pride goes to a wizard, becomes a wizard. Pride, wizard. Flag out means two, then switch. So, follow, follow. If there's separation, escape. No separation, switch. Then we'll add the Peterson, the Granby to it, just for a big point. So follow, cut the shoulder. And just come in. Just come in the palm. I mean, cut the shoulder in. Two. One more time. Make sure you're doing this. Make sure you don't have your butt on the side of your hip. When you land on your side of your hip, your body's turning. Your body, if you land on your hip, turn your hip. Right here, right there. You land here like that. You should be land right here and then you should land right here, just like this. That way my body.
land here and then stay here. So when you land, when you try, if you land like that, it's so gonna be right here. It makes it harder for me to keep control.
So what you wanna do, you wanna land.
Hit here and drop your left shoulder down. Yeah. You should be at that point now. You need to drop your left shoulder down so you can get in quicker. Drop your left shoulder. Yep. Okay. Better.
Hip drop.
See how square?
Hip drop.
Square.
Drop square and then it's not like
that.
Compared to the way you used in the beginning, you know. Hip, side hip.
Because even when he follows, he gets scared. Because he sees that he needs to follow and he doesn't lose him. But then he can send him up.
He loses the animation, right?
Yes. So now to do that next.
Yeah. You have two ways of doing it. One, you either step over the leg and then roll, shoulder roll forward. Or step over the leg and stick to your butt backwards.
Do whichever one you prefer.
Do both. You need to know both because you might stop one and get on the other one. So go to your feet and step over the leg. As soon as you can't catch that hand, you should be rubbing it right away. Lock it up. Even if you're not easy, that should be like the main thing.
Do I catch something like at 4? No, at 3.
Lock it up. Step over, and then you're going to try to go back, you have a problem, and then go forward. That's it. Don't drop your shoulder and your hip. Right shoulder, right hip. You're going to move like a fat man. You follow, and you're going to try to go back, it stops you, and now just go forward now. Okay? Now what you got to do now is like, sometimes you'll panic. I'm not sure what you do, like I think that you do. Sometimes you'll do it wrong and you'll end up doing this instead. You want to do me here, and then you'll challenge him, and he'll do it right, and then So if you have a hard time, you can't take it back. You should be backwards. That way you can't, you try to pull you, you'll be able to just be on it. Yeah, switch. So I'll do the other one now. I'm sorry, my mistake. Yeah, just like that. It's almost like you sort of sit. You're like, sort of sit. But this one, you're just going to hit. The other one goes to the front. Yeah. But you still try to hit that. You understand? Make sure you remember that. Don't go back to your bad habits. It's very important to get this right. If you really want to be successful in this position. Good. Exactly. Good. Next step. Yeah. Good. Hey, and just because they follow you doesn't mean you're doing it wrong. You just happen to follow you. But that's why we have these other moves. They do follow you. I like the way you're doing it now. Hey, now you got it. Don't forget that.
Good again. I want you to turn more left when you're doing the first one and second one.
Oh, you
if you're still doing that, it's good. I want you to get side, same side. Sometimes, you know, what happens, you do too, go right, like that, follow him, right there, grab me, you're gonna stop. This is when you do the grab me, you don't want to step forward, because he's so tight, come here, let's say he's right here, come here, he'll be right here, especially when he's here, okay, you can still do it. See what I'm saying? He'll be right here, he'll be thinking, oh man, he didn't get away, right? He said, oh man, I didn't get away. Right there, doesn't matter. Get your grammy. Grab that, lock it, go forward. There's your grammy. You don't even know how deadly this combination is. It's like
going.
This was it. It can't stop me.
I'm going.
You can't believe it.
Try to get one, try to get your escape. If he follows you, go for your Peterson or switch, paddock, or whatever. Just good move. Depending on what he does, what do you see? Come back again. I want you to do all the moves, but you don't do them. See what it gets you going. Switch. Remember, you know how to do all these moves? Guess what? Why is this move good? Can they leg grab you? No. Why? Because you're out. Can they chop you and keep you there? No. Can they do legs and grab the leg? No. And you hit me. Make sure you line up with this. Make sure you get this. That's where you do that. Make sure you're okay. Make sure you get the knee. It's okay. You should got it. No, she got it. Do it again. See, the thing about it is that you can't panic. You can't identify you for this. Oh, it's not there. And you gotta see something else is gonna be there. You should have switched. If he's there, you got to switch still. You switch Peterson Graham. But it doesn't matter if you can get away. I still haven't seen an escape though. That's what you want to perfect. You want to escape just because, you know, this is a big deal, whatever. But then follow you, and then it's like, okay, well, follow me, see what happens. Pretend it's a real match. Just try to escape. If you can't escape, he doesn't let you escape, then you got these other dangerous moves. The other guy. Try to get you escape though. I haven't seen an escape yet. Hit flag out. Back out. Remember that, okay? That's the flag out is your whole basis. The whole foundation. Go. If you could escape, you could do all the other moves. How's that? If you could escape, that means you could do all the other moves because that means you can stay in there if you want to now. Because you know you could escape if you want to.
That's okay. What you got? What you got? Grab that wrist. You can do it. You can do it again. If you grab that wrist, then you can do your other moves too. Head up. Stop. Come back. Good. I notice you keep your head down. Keep your head up. There's a reason for it. Keep your head up. You'll land on your hips more square. If you're like this, you'll slide more. If your head's down, you tend to slide more. Head up, you'll land, you'll get air, and you'll land flatter. So keep your head up. That way you could land flatter on your hip. Otherwise, you'll slide because you're looking down. Sounds crazy, but that's what happens. Head up. Yeah, like that. Switch it. You gotta get that skate position so that you could do these other moves. You'll be in perfect position. Yeah, right there. Switch it. You understand? If you could escape, then you don't need to worry about anything. These other ones would be just big gravy points. Do that again, but I want you to do a Peterson though. The Peterson will require less power than the Granby. Peterson. It's all hip. You get it?
Yeah.
It's all hip work. So, you know, just letting you know that the Peterson, it's easier to do than the other one, than the Granby, because the Granby, it can still do it. Okay, let's move on. Let's do the bar. Oh, yeah, go down. Okay, back pedal. I want you to back pedal and army back, reverse army crawl. Army crawl. Army crawl and back pedal. Go down. That'll get a bar. Go to your 90. Go to your 90. He'll follow you. Grab the wrist. Grab Peterson. Peterson. Do it again. That's there for you all day long when you see it. So, an army crawl, knee slide 90, and then Peterson. Just, he's going to follow you. He's going to have his hand around your waist. Back pedal, back pedal, back pedal.
Back pedal, slide, he's there, like that, exactly what's going to happen.
by is just to get to your knees. And he'll be set up at the night. So Jesus, you slide, you follow right there. See? Step. And then you go through the shoulder roll. So knee slide, I mean, you know, back pedal, army crawl, down. Army crawl, back pedal, army crawl, yeah, right there. Step, step forward. Got the arm, stop. You can't, come back, feet in, knees, feet in, feet, all right. Power and a half, same thing. Come here. He dressed on, he does the power and a half. First thing he's here, lock up. Head up, lock up, and back pedal. Break the power, get him off you. And then he's gonna come right back here. So make sure you never look down. You have got to have a feeling that last year. You had it this year a little bit, just starting and practicing. Head up all the time. So you get it good. So head up, lock down, back pedal with the lock. This is low on here. Head up. A table here when you're looking down. See, the table is your neck. Your neck is weak. You don't want it to be in your neck. That's a weak spot. So you want to go up. That way he can't put it. Now he's more like on his shoulder. It's harder. There's more power against him. Now you have a chance to beat this guy over here too. So you don't want him to beat this part and that part. Head up in here. So when he puts it in, so anytime you're down here, you get your head up. Keep your head up. You're doing this, you're gonna come back up. Okay, up, and then get back up. When you're right here, he gets on you, you're looking up, up, up. Now even if he does that, you're set. It's hard for him to get that start. See that? You're down, you're in trouble now. He's got leverage. You understand? So and when you're right here, you move in here and he puts the power half. Now lock up. Move back in here and you're up. At least you now you're at least at a higher, better position. Okay. Go ahead. All you guys did the same mistake. Keanu did the same thing. Go ahead. If you win the match, the next thing you know, throw a power half on him, he gets turned over because he looks down. Don't look down. Oh, lean the mat on the bottom like this. Keep your head up, strong. You don't want to power half on your hand. Go. Keep your head up. So you lock the elbow, head up, back the tail, and go to the knee side and you get forward. Head up. Again. Anytime you flat, head up. Strong. If you don't do that,
check it down. Watch the difference. See the difference? Right? The head and neck is weak. Now look up. It's hard. Now it's hard. Now go check it down. Put your head now work down. See? Huh? Now put your head up. See that? That's all you gotta do. You want extra power? Lift your head. Keep it up 100% of the time. Good. Head up. Do your move with your head up, lock down the elbow. See that?
Right. Oh, you got to the left.
Switch.
Head up. Fail. Head up. Work your head up. Your neck is down in your shoulder. So now it's
he's right here. He's very strong. He's going to go down right here. Now, the problem with you guys, everybody in our team, is that whenever you guys get this, if you get it, you got to stay on this side. Right here, he's got this. If you don't get this, he's even worse for you. So right here, once you get this, even if you can't get it, it doesn't matter. You're just going to jump over. Jump over, throw the half. And then walk it right here. You want to throw the half, and if he's winging down, if he wings down, you're going to come inside the leg. Pull. And walk on the head. Okay?
But you also have to tilt. Wing, tilt.
No, go to the top. Tripod. 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 Front tripod. Referee's position.
Referee's position.
Referee's position. Do tripod. Tripod. Yeah, right there. Jump over. Don't wait. No. Yeah. Jump over. Don't stay there. Jump over. Never stay on the same side. Otherwise, you're going to have big fights. Throw the hat. And make sure you see the elbow, the left side. You see the elbow is not too tight. Yeah. You got to make sure you bring this elbow. Make sure you see the elbow. Trust me, your size will do that. Walk around the head. There you are. Knees strap the face, the knee, the face, the head, knee. Yeah. Roll over. Okay, switch. Switch it. That's gonna be mostly your weight class, huh?
My weight class?
Yeah, that's what I like to do. Seriously, they like a tripod. Go ahead. Tripod. Head in the, no. Keep the hand on the waist. Head in the head, the driver. No, back. Keep the hand where you can see the same. Keep your hand here. Just put your hand here and drive forward. Bring it down. Keep the hand on the waist too. Everything is the same. Drive it here, right there. And now keep that. On your toes. Head in the head, now come back. On your toes, keep the head lever. Now knee, slide your right knee in. Yeah, wing it. One on one on the right. Pull. Walk the head. No. You can walk the head with me hard. So jump over. Go the half. Now walk the head. And you have the elbow, stay up out. That means you can walk the head. Walk it. Step around. Step and walk the head. No, come back. You're working too hard. Come back. Hey. Walk around the head. Hey, step around the head. You're working too hard. We call it walk the clock. It means like this, tick-tock, right? Wing it, one-on-one. You ready? Now, see the elbow? Make sure your elbow's out. Now, walk the clock, walk around. Walk around the clock, walk around. Walk around, there you go. Rub the head, or step over, Get back, do it again. So when we say walk the clock, that means walk around the front.
Is that a pinning?
Huh?
Is that a pinning?
It could be a pinning, yeah. It's gonna be a pinning. It is. But I like to sit. Tripods again. The tripods, and if he goes all the way up, you're gonna come underneath. You're gonna pull his waist, and this head this becomes this, like a navy right. Alright? It comes here. You're gonna pull, and you're gonna pull. Here.
Drop.
Here.
Elbow behind the neck. Drop.
Here.
Lift the head. All right.
That's fine.
Hurts.
Let's try it. So you're basically going to create, it's called a spear to a navy right. To a bat, say. Pull. Good. Grab the one-on-one on the right side. Pull it in. Lift up. One, two, three. You're going to go. Don't pin yourself. Bat series. Towards the back pocket. Drop chest. Okay, stop. Switch it. Switch it. You're down. Step up a little bit and lift up the head. Step your foot over, up forward. Yeah, right there, lift the head. Lift up the top right hand. Okay. All right, the next move. You got that? Also, ready? Down. Do two more moves in this position. He gets up and up. Also, you have to start showing you what you guys can do with them. Here, you're going to keep the hand on the waist. You try to pause. You're going to keep the hand on the waist. You're going to drop the left hand on the ankle, behind the ankles. The right hand then comes up and scoops right here. So it goes up. Here. This goes on the track on that. This is going first. Okay. So this hand goes here to the this hand goes right here to the bicep. And this goes here on the elbow, on the knee. Here you would drive this way. Drop your knee this way, actually. You drop your knee, see what you did. So the options are this way or let's go. So this thing he's holding on, he doesn't want to go this way. Then I'm going to go this way. He doesn't want to go. I feel power, he doesn't want to go. And I'm going to go this way then. So, I think I'm going this way. He doesn't want to go. He doesn't want to go. Now go here. This way.
What?
Right.
What?
Okay, try it. Tripod. Go to the ankle. Keep the waist there behind the knee. By the way, here. I'm gonna pick it up. Down, there, right up. Yeah, good. Now go to the knee, go to drop your back, down, back, then go. Now you go this way, here, then go, and go down. You're going to be here. Then this hand's going to come here. Here. Okay? So you're going to be right here. And then you're going to go here to this place. Okay? Butterfly. He gets up. Come on. Drops down like this, you can't get it, right? So you're going to go here, put your knee here, drop this way, here. Then you're finishing up here.
This is always me, coach.
I can't do it to him, it's too small. You get it?
So go to your butterfly lock, go to one-on-one. He's going to drop his shoulder down, then he's going to go to step in, forward, drop. One on one. Right away, you got to go to the other one to call you for locking up. He drops his shoulder down, drop his shoulder down.
Okay, pull. Yeah, okay. Now, let go the leg.
Step up, hook up.
Right there.
Right away, okay? You got that 2 seconds to grab that hand. Got it? You drop the shoulder. Hook.
Bring it in. Yeah. And then, no. Come back. Okay. This hand, you're going to finish this hand. On your knees right here. You're going to slip it through and drop your shoulder right here so it doesn't slip away.
All right.
So it's going to be this. And then you're going to drop your shoulder so he doesn't slip, and then this to lock him in. All right? One more time.
Right away, take that one-on-one. He drops the shoulder down, pull the leg. Get some water break real quick and let's get to some conditioning. I heard that. Set. You guys count. 25. Get ready. So again.
17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
again. Don't you guys feel like Hulks now, like Superman now?
Huh?
Don't you guys feel like you guys are Superman now? It builds up your top, you know, and also your right here chest, and also the top and the wings. And last set, get ready. Go ahead. Those are the kind of burns that you like, though. Eventually, they'll benefit you. Okay, go ahead and start jogging. Sprint to straight. Let's go. Sprint it straight. I know it's not easy, but when you have somebody in front of you, it's not going to be harder. If you don't get to do that now, it'll be harder when somebody's in front of your face. If you don't have no energy, you have no power. I don't care how strong you are. Right? Right? Where's your power now? Right? Exactly my point.
He's trying to screw up without my shoes.
What? Oh yeah, get your water break real quick, and we're gonna do some more real quick, just to give you a break. You got 10 minutes left.
Hurry up, get your water break. Oh. Thank you.
Push-ups on your fingertips. 10. Ten sit-ups. Jog it. Sprint to straight. You have like a mat. Like a match and a half. So act like it. Push-ups on your fingertips. 10. Jog it. Sprint to straight. Championship round. Act like it. Army crawl. Relax, but stay strong. Bear crawl. Jog it. Sprint to straight. Everybody's watching. Right there, stop right there, and then meet him over there, jumping jacks. Split jumping jacks, 25.
On you guys?
Yeah, on you guys. Strong minds.
Don't whine. Okay, right there, that's the last set right here. Burpees. Eat your vegetables.
How many, coach?
Six count. 15. Right here in the circle, over there in the circle, right circle. After that, we do your 7 up downs, and that's it. You're done. Stay strong. Last round.
Wait,
6
count is 1 push-up?
Yeah. I'll call it. I'll do it. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Call it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
3.
Jump. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
4.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
8.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
9.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
11.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
12.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
13.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
14.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
15.
They're right there. 7 up downs.
On you, coach.
Yeah, me. Move. Fake the shot, fake shots. Attitude, be aggressive attitude, offensive attitude. Sprout.
One.
Attack attitude. You gotta put pressure on the guy so he doesn't come at you. If you're just defending, he's gonna come all day long.
Oh.
Be careful with the sock. Sprout.
Two.
Attitude. Aggressive attitude. Sprout.
Three.
Sprout.
Four.
Look at each other, face each other. Level change each other. Shadow each other. Very important in chat to do that. Sprout.
Five.
Shadow him. It's important when you're tired to shadow, otherwise you're gonna lose. Because that's gonna take you down when you're tired. You gotta do that. All the fakes, you gotta match. You gotta match him. Follow him. Sprout.
Six.
Make him move. Make him drop. You want him to drop. Sprout.
Seven.
Up. Down.
One.
Down.
Two.
Down.
Three.
Down.
Four.
Down.
Five.
Down.
Six.
Down.
Seven.
Shake the door, she wouldn't leave.
job, guys. See you guys tomorrow.
Wait, tomorrow, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, tomorrow.